Hey guys, it's Stir, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Sonic the Hedgehog movie. Of course I would be doing that. It's been a while since I've made a video. It's been 5 months since I've made another video. I apologize for that. I've been having a lot of other important priorities. I just got accepted into college, so yay. But let's just ignore that for right now and talk about my experience and perspective of this film. So I actually celebrated this movie as like a birthday thing because I don't know why, but like all of the movies I always want to see, they always come out in February. February is my birthday month. Like for example, the Lego movie came out in February, Sponge Out of Water came out in February, Deadpool came out in February, Alita Battle Angel came out in February, the Lego Batman movie came out in February, and now Sonic has taken that spotlight. My favorite childhood game. So that's really cool. I should talk about my history with this film. Back in the summer of 2014, I had to miss out on a lot of hot E3 news because I was at sixth grade camp. There was no Wi-Fi at all, but it was fun. It was a great high note to celebrate before graduating elementary school, but because my weeb nerdy mindset was too busy not admiring the beauty of nature and friendship, I just grew impatient throughout the entire trip, just waiting to get home so I could go online and look at some gamer news. So as soon as I got home, I ran towards my laptop like the blue blur himself. There was a new poster for the SpongeBob movie Sponge Out of Water, some interesting new footage of some upcoming Nintendo games that would later impact the entire company, like Splatoon and Smash Bros. For Wii U. There was new footage of Sonic Boom, a show that I was very hyped for and ended up loving in the long run. And if you guys want, you can go see my review for the Sonic Boom series. It's like my first video on this channel. However, the biggest news that had me flabbergasted was one major announcement. They were finally making a Sonic the Hedgehog movie, something I had always dreamed of ever since I was a child. Although rather being excited, I was also slightly scared. This was during a time when live-action adaptations of like cartoony characters was almost just constantly dead on the spot. Crappy movies like Alvin the Chipmunks, Smurfs, the live-action Scooby-Doo movies. Those are just a few examples of other films that have that tired formula. You guys already know. What didn't help was that Ninja Turtles was on the way like the same year as this film was announced. And not only that, but we didn't even have a decent American video game film just yet. This wasn't around the time when Detective Pikachu, I don't even think it was announced. I think the Sonic movie was announced before they announced a Detective Pikachu movie. What's weird is that this was originally going to be a Sony movie too. You already know that that company is extremely infamous, but this movie was planned to be darker, edgier. They even called it the Dark Knight treatment, Sony did. Well, I do love Sonic Boom. I was getting a little bit too tired of like recent Sonic games experimenting with humor instead of incorporating the intensity from previous games. So I did get a little bit hyped that this was aiming for a PG-13 rating initially, but even though I did imagine it would be refreshing to see a dark Sonic storyline again, I was also at the same time worried that this would be a story that takes itself way too seriously. I mean, it's a story about a fast, cartoony anthropomorphic hedgehog that wears gloves and shoes in a live-action setting. Can you imagine if they took that like extremely seriously? That would be hilarious. Oh yeah, that reminds me. Before we saw the design, the crappy design for Sonic in the trailer, Sega did say that Sonic wouldn't be getting a major redesign in this film. That was a mindset they had from the very beginning. So keep that in mind before I start talking about the trailer. After all these announcements, the film got delayed multiple times, just about every single year even. They announced a date for 2015, I think, then 2016, and then I think 2017, and then 2018, until eventually this entire movie got bought by Paramount. And there were new film writers to replace the old ones. The guy who directed Deadpool ends up being a producer. The film now has a legitimate release date, November 8th, 2019. And not only that, but we got a glimpse of the plot. Small town sheriff Tom Wachowski goes on a journey to San Francisco in efforts to assist a juvenile delinquent, Sonic, a blue anthropomorphic hedgehog, in his battle against the evil Dr. Robotnik, while the government is trying to catch him at the same time. I was terrified when I heard this news. Sonic teaming up with a cop, another generic government after alien ET story. Not only that, but I checked the resumes of the people writing this film, Patrick Casey and Josh Miller, and oh my god, they have made some pretty horrible films. I'm sorry, guys. Two of their movies have literally 0% on Rotten Tomatoes. I know that's kind of unfair to say because that just means that 0% of critics enjoyed the movie, but whatever. Also around this time, I was beginning to notice a pattern with why American video game movies ended up being constantly terrible. I talked about this in my Detective Pikachu video. They always hire people with bad resumes. I don't know why. Seriously, go look at the resumes of every person who worked on a video game movie that came out before 2017. They're all bad. They're all people with bad resumes. And when I figured out that the writers of Guardians of the Galaxy and like people who wrote for DreamWorks movies were working on Detective Pikachu, I figured from the very start that even before the trailers released, Detective Pikachu would probably be like one of the best video game movies. Sonic, though, I was still skeptical as hell about, just because of those two writers. I was honestly convinced that it would be doomed from the start. This was before we even got to see the poster. I wasn't surprised by the poster design. When they moved it to Paramount, and when I figured out about the people writing on this film, I wasn't shocked. even though producers like Tim Miller, who worked on Deadpool, Neil H. Moretz, who worked on the Fast and Furious films, were working on this film, and even some people who work at Sega were involved, apparently, I was still just scared of what the writing would do. That's the most important job of a movie, in my opinion. One of, at least. But here's the thing. There was a test screening in February 2019. And according to... There was like a Reddit leak that came out around that time. And the person was saying that, like, oh no, it's actually a surprisingly decent movie. I was seeing also some posts on Facebook of people who got to see the film early saying that they actually did enjoy it. Again, test screening. And I got to look at a little bit of the plot, and it did seem like I was looking at this and thinking, okay, this could be executed pretty well. But then the trailer comes out, and... oh my god, that design. Here's the thing, is that I, like, even with the poster, I was thinking, okay, we haven't seen the entire design yet. Maybe it'll look better in motion, but nope. The trailer just embarrasses the hell out of it, the film itself, the entire franchise itself. It would have been, like, the biggest embarrassment of Sega history, of Sonic the Hedgehog history. And it was pretty whack. I remember seeing that trailer and like thinking, okay, it's kind of cool that we get to see Sonic and Eggman like fighting on the big screen in live action. But that design, man, it was overwhelming so many people. It felt crushing. And I was just thinking in my head, they have to redesign this character. If they don't, I don't know what's going to happen. And, you know, most film companies do not take constructive criticism. Remember that whole Butch Hartman thing? Okay, he's not a film company himself, but, like, a lot of people in Hollywood will just be like, oh, fuck you, whenever they hear constructive criticism. Surprisingly, Jeff Fowler, the director of this film, who's actually worked on Sonic games in the past before, by the way, I think Tim Miller did too, he took constructive criticism. He was being smart, and he was like, all right, you got it. Let's redesign the character. Let's be nice to the fans. We can do it. And then they delay the movie all the way to Valentine's Day, which I think was also a smart choice too, because in like November, that's around the same time that Frozen 2 came out and Star Wars was coming out. So that's pretty great. And again, near my birthday, which was pretty cool. Yeah, with all of that being said, and I did defend this film because I was starting to, after I heard about the test screening and everything and how one of the writer said that there wouldn't be fart jokes in the movie, which was a complete lie. There is a bit of that. Let's just talk about my thoughts on the film itself. Again, I saw it on Valentine's Day. It was a blast. Best Valentine's Day I've ever had, since I've never had, like, a date or anything on Valentine's Day. But it was just a whole bunch of single nerds, except for my two friends who were a couple. Like, 25 people showed up. I got gifts from friends. It was a blast. Anyway, the movie. Let's focus on the movie. I thought Sonic the Hedgehog was a very, very flawed, but extremely fun film. It's interesting how Sony originally intended for this to be a dark and gritty adaptation with a PG-13 rating, but I think when Paramount picked it up again, it just became a hard PG, like Detective Pikachu. I'm kind of shocked that this film still maintained the rating that it did, though, because there is some stuff that they surprisingly get away with. The reason why I also brought up the film's history is that this kind of thing actually happened to the Super Mario Bros. Movie, the live action one. It was originally supposed to be darker and grittier and stuff, and it had a completely different production team. But then when Disney, or like a side company of Disney, bought it, it just completely like collapsed, and they did like a whole bunch of poor decisions. And in a way, I think the Sonic movie is actually the Mario Brothers movie done right. I mean, to be honest, if you replace all of the Mario characters in the Mario movie with just some generic made-up characters, like the movie would still be the same thing. It would just have different names for characters. If you replace Sonic and Robotnik in this film with some random fast alien character and a scientist played by Jim Carrey, it would pretty much mostly be the same film as well. The movie is fast-paced. The pacing is really fast. Clearly, that's done on purpose, and there's just constant wackiness and wit in every scene. I'm not really sure why they originally wanted Sonic to look super realistic and humanoid in this film, because Sonic acts really cartoony and Looney Tunes-ish in this film. Like, he's like a child. He's like a little child Sonic, and it's really entertaining to see him grow. And he's also, this is a much more nicer Sonic too. Like, he does make fun of Robotnik a lot, just like what Sonic would do. It stays true to Sonic's character, but like, it's a child-friendly, innocent Sonic the Hedgehog, which I thought was really cool. And because they redesigned the character, though, I thought not only did it fix the look of the character, but it fixed the visual gags of the film itself. There's a lot of visual gags in this movie. When the time freezing stuff happens, it's so cool. When the action, this isn't really an action movie, but when it does happen, it's really cool. Another thing I have to praise is the intimidating yet hilarious performance of Jim Carrey. Of course, everyone knew he was going to do great. Ben Schwartz does a great portrayal of Sonic, just like I said. And surprisingly, even the human characters are pretty charming. That's something that, like, almost every live-action adaptation with a cartoon character and a human character just fail at doing. Even Detective Pikachu's human characters weren't really that great. Like, I was fine with them. They were tolerable, but they weren't, like, very deep. I was actually kind of sympathizing and laughing at some of the things that the human characters did. I thought Tom the cop had like a true passion. I thought that like he had a really sincere idea of what he wanted to do as a cop. I thought that his wife and him, I thought it was really charming and funny how they interacted. And then his wife's family is just hilarious. You'd have to see the movie. Anyway, with all of that being said though, this, like I said, it's a flawed movie. It's not a great movie. Good, but not great. Honestly, I'm kind of mixed between which film I like more, Detective Pikachu or Sonic. Sonic's comedy is definitely superior to Detective Pikachu's, but whenever the Sonic movie tried being serious, that fast pacing just ruined it, especially at the beginning when they try to explain the origin of Sonic and his past and how he gets to Earth. It's just way too fast. That scenes like that needed to be a bit longer, and how like it tries to delve into this message about loneliness, which I honestly think could have been really sweet, but the pacing just ruins that. That's something Detective Pikachu did good with. Whenever Detective Pikachu tried being serious, there was like this wholesome atmosphere, and Detective Pikachu has a lot of flaws too. But I notice a few. I notice like one or two, maybe even three plot holes in this movie. One of them could have been fixed if Sonic wasn't wearing gloves, but he originally wasn't going to be wearing gloves in this movie. So, and while Sonic can be threatened easily, they did kind of make him a little bit too powerful in this. Kind of like what happened to Superman in the DCEU and what they did with Captain Marvel. But I assume it's at least tolerable to most people because this is clearly a comedy. It's not taking itself too seriously. Don't expect this to be some deep, impactful superhero film. I would probably give Sonic a rough 7 or 6 out of 10. The film has some very funny, risky moments, interesting visual gags, and great performances with charming characters, but the humor, when the humor doesn't work, it really doesn't work, by the way. Like, there is three jokes that I didn't really enjoy, and it was One of them was pretty bad. It is a fart joke, by the way, one of the ones that I'm talking about. And again, the pacing will probably throw some people off during the first viewing. Ultimately, though, I think Sonic is a very flawed but fun film. It is definitely one of the greater American video game film adaptations, and I had a lot of fun watching it. I'm Stir, and like always, I don't know how to end video.